And now Uchul Nikam has responded to the allegations made by Vijay Wadithawaz. He says, and I'm quoting him, he says, "I pity on that irresponsible opposition leader. He's making all these baseless allegations while doing his politics. He's harming image of the country. Even Kasab confessed to his crimes," Uchul Nikam said. Let's listen in to what the former prosecutor and now turned politician had to say on the issue.
Vijay Wadethiwar has leveled serious allegations against you, saying that you protected Ajmal Kasab by not revealing that the bullet which killed Hemant Karkare was not fired by any of the terrorists. What do you have to say for that?
I have really pity on that responsible opposition leader, because it is making such reckless, baseless allegations which are going to help government of Pakistan. I don't know on what basis he's making such allegations. Really, it's a surprising that while doing politics, you are ruining the image of our country, because it has been proved by the prosecution that the deceased Karkare, Kamte and Sayaskar died on account of the indiscriminate firing of Ajmal Amir Kasab and Abu Jindal. Abu Ismail.
But sir, he has claimed that he has not made these allegations by himself, and that in fact a retired police officer, S.M. Mushrif, has written a book about it, and that all these things were brushed aside during trial stage.
It is relying upon one retired police officer contention. Then why he is making the Goebbels propaganda unless he had seen the proven facts? He should have taken the pains to read the whole evidence and then should arrive at his conclusion.
Vinaya Deshpande, who spoke to Uchul Nikam, is now joining us on the broadcast. Vinaya, Uchul Nikam completely dismissive of all the allegations, but it's election season. How's the BJP and the Congress both interpreting the fallout of these latest allegations?
Well, absolutely. See, for the BJP, it thinks that this is something that will hamper the Congress itself, because it says, the sources that I spoke to, and even Uchul Nikam spoke on record, saying that, this is something that has been politically motivated. It has been brought out years after the trial and after the judgments have proven that it was Kasab and other terrorists because of whom Hemant Karkare was martyred. And that is why now that this fresh controversy has erupted after Vijay Wadethiwar spoke. Clearly, the BJP has been giving a reply to the same. Uchul Nikam also, while speaking to CNN News 18, said that it wasn't just at the trial court, but also the Supreme Court, which had taken cognizance of all the statements that the terrorists had recorded, their statements which had been recorded, and that is why it was proven beyond doubt. And such statements like that, like these, will only end helping Pakistan. So clearly, at a time when the election season is on, the Congress says that the BJP is trying to protect a traitor who did not bring all the facts to light during the trial stage, and claims that a retired police officer has written a book saying that Hemant Karkare died not because of a bullet of a terrorist, but because of a bullet which was fired by a police officer who was then linked to the RSS. So at such a juncture when election time is going on, this has created political turmoil in Maharashtra. It has led to a lot of reactions. We have seen Fadnavis as well target the Congress, saying that, the Congress stands by Pakistan and by Kasab, whereas the BJP stands with Uchul Nikam. So we expect that the political controversy over this will continue, because even Vijay Wadethiwar hasn't really backed off from his statement. He has only said that the interpretation is politically motivated.
So Vijay Wadethiwar is trying to do some kind of a damage control by saying these are not my words, these are words of a retired police officer. But what are the credentials of this retired police officer? Why does Wadethiwar think that his words are gospel truth?
Well, we've seen that this is not new for all of us. In Mumbai, we have covered the 2611 trial. We have seen even when the book was written by S.M. Mushrif, there was controversy. There were several conspiracy theories with respect to which discussions had happened time as well, but it wasn't really taken very seriously. Remember, at that stage, the trial was completed, and we had the prosecution had proven that it was the terrorists who had fired indiscriminately, because of which not just Hemant Karkare but other police officers as well lost their lives. They were martyred during that attack. So at this juncture, years after the trial has been over, the fact that Ujjwal Nikam, who was then the special public prosecutor and who fought that case for prosecution, is now the BJP candidate from Mumbai North Central, has led to resurfacing of the kind of conspiracy theories that were given in that book at that time.
Right.
But clearly, the BJP says there is no credence to it. Ujjwal Nikam, while speaking to CNN News 18, said that the trial had completely, without any fault, proven that it was the terrorist whose firing led to those deaths. Back to you.
Vinaya, thank you so much. Like Vinaya was mentioning, this has become a political hot potato in the run-up to elections in Mumbai. There are a lot of reactions coming in. Let's dip in.
अभी समझ में आया कि कांग्रेस पार्टी के लिए सीधा पाकिस्तान से दुआएं क्यों आ रही है, क्यों राहुल गांधी और कांग्रेस पार्टी सत्ता में आए पाकिस्तान क्यों लगातार इबादत कर रहा है, क्योंकि कांग्रेस पार्टी के सबसे वरिष्ठ नेता महाराष्ट्र में जो लीडर ऑफ ऑपोजिशन है विजय वडेट्टीवार, वो पाकिस्तान को 26/11 पर क्लीन चिट दे देते हैं, कहते हैं कि शहीद हेमंत करकरे की हत्या पाकिस्तान के आतंकियों ने नहीं, अजमल कसाब जैसे आतंकियों ने नहीं, बल्कि हिंदुओं ने ही की है, जिन्होंने राष्ट्रहित के लिए अपनी वकालत के माध्यम से आतंकियों को और पाकिस्तान प्रायोजित आतंकवाद को फांसी के तख्ते पर पहुंचाया, उस उज्ज्वल निकम को देशद्रोही कहते हैं। देशद्रोही तो वो है जो नक्सलियों को शहीद कहते हैं, जो सेना को बलात्कारी कहते हैं और जो अफजल और याकूब के लिए आंसू बहाते हैं।
You can hate a particular person, you can hate a particular leader, you can oppose a particular leader, you can oppose an ideology, but to hate your own country, to support the enemy of your country is extremely shameful. I have never heard this kind of statement before, I have never seen this kind of politics before. I can't imagine that a party like the Congress would stoop so low as to blame a religion in India and blame domestic forces over Pakistan for 26/11, not once, but twice.